In this session, we will discuss IDEA algorithm. IDEA means International Data Encryption Standard algorithm. This IDEA algorithm follows Feistel-Cypher approach. Feistel-Cypher approach we already discussed. That is simply the text is divided into different number of blocks, perform operation on one block and make the XOR operation with the left part and again perform some calculations. Now coming to IDEA algorithm, in IDEA algorithm the plain text size of the plain text is 64 bits. Now these 64 bits are divided into 4 blocks. Concept is divide the plain text into different number of blocks. These 64 bits is divided into 4 blocks. That is size of each block is 16. 4 blocks. Next, key size. Key size is 128 bits. And number of rounds. Number of rounds are 17. These are the predefined functions. Plain text of size 64 bits. Size of the key is 128 bit. And number of rounds are 17. Now these 128 bit key is divided into different number of sub keys based on number of rounds. So next we will move to that topic. The brief discussion of IDEA algorithm is, the first the plain text is divided into 4 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks. This size is 64 bit. Once the 4 blocks are converted, this is applied into round 1 operation. The input 64 bit is applied into round 1 operation. For each round, we have to take some input. At the same time, we have to produce some key. So, key size is some 128 bit key. From 128 bit key, we have to perform key expansion. That is some key generation. We have to perform some key generation. From this key, we are generating 4 keys. K1, K2, K3, K4. For round 1, we are input providing as 4 blocks and 4 keys. Size of each block is 16. Similarly, size of this one is 16. After completion of round 1, it generates to round 2. For round 2 also, it generates some keys. Here the keys are K5 and K6 only. Similarly, apply round 17 operation. We have a total of 17 rounds. For round 17, we have last K1, K5, K6 and up to the last key is some K52. That is K49, K50, K51, K52. These are the 4 keys. After completion of 17 rounds, it produces a ciphertext of 64 bytes in each block of 16 bytes. This is the procedure of IDEA algorithm. So by observing this one, first point is key expansion. That is the 128 bit key is expanded into 52 sub keys. Next we will discuss this one. And round 1, round 3, round 5, 7 are each odd rounds take 4 keys and each even round takes only 2 keys. So this is the block diagram of IDEA algorithm. First we will discuss how we perform key expansion. Next we will move how to perform operations on each round. So coming to key expansion. So the size of the key is 128 bit. This 128 bit key is divided into K1, K2, K3, K4, K5, K6, K7 and K8. Initially the 128 bit key is converted into this format K1 to K8, 16. Each block we have only 8 keys and each block of size 16 bytes. So 16 into 8, 128. This is the procedure for converting. First 8 keys are generated, but according to our algorithm, our key is converted into 52 sub keys. Our key is converted into 52 sub keys and each sub key of size 16 bytes. So the procedure for generating next 8 keys, is simply, this is a 128 bit key. Add 128 bit key once again. Simply 128 bit, append again the 128 bits. In this, generate the key from 25th bit. Here we are generating the key from 0 bit onwards. In the next iteration, generate the keys from 25th bit, that is from 25th to 16. We are generating K9, K10 and so on K16. After completion, generating the keys from 48th bit for K17 to K24. This is the procedure for expanding of key. From first two iteration we directly got the keys. From next iteration onwards starts from 25th bit. By starting from 25th bit, in the next iteration we are using 24 bits. In simple terms, this is a circular shift operation. This is the expansion of keys. Next we will move to round operations, are of two types. Rounds are of two types. One is odd round, second one is even round. Odd round and even round. And for each round, the plain text size is 64 bits. That is, we are divided into 4 blocks. Assume the blocks are XA, XB, XC and XD. For even round also, the blocks are XA, XB, XC, XD. That is, this is the block size. Initially, in the block diagram, we are divided into 4 blocks. This is XA, XB, XC and XD. According to algorithm, for odd round, we are providing 4 keys. Assume the keys are KA, KB, KC, KD. For even round, we are providing only 2 keys, KE and KF. Now our aim is how to perform operation on each round, that is on how to perform operation on odd round by using these 4 keys, perform operation on even round by using these 2 keys. First we will discuss odd round operations. For example, the floor blocks are XA, XB, XC, XD. These are the 4 blocks. In the first step, XA with KA. Here this symbol is simply a modification of multiplication. Generally we have 3 types of symbols. This one, this is XR operation, and this one a modification of multiplication, and this one modification of addition. This is normal, not addition, normal multiplication. So normal addition, normal multiplications are not here. This is some slightly change addition, slightly change modification. This is well known XR operation. XA and KA, it produces some result XA. That is in round 1, for first block, we are applying this operation. By applying this operation, this is new XA and this is applied to round 2. Similarly, for last block also, we are performing the same operation KD, it produces XD. So for first block and last block, simply perform operation with corresponding key. For these two blocks, for XB, perform operation with KB. Similarly, in this, perform operation, simply this is addition with KC. Now it produces some result. This result is copied as XB and this result is copied as XC. Observe the pattern. First and last are directly placed and second and third blocks are simply interchange the result. That is, in simple term, top represents old terms, of long represents new terms. XA is equal to, that is old XA is equal to XA into KA, XB is equal to XC plus KC, XC is equal to XB plus KB, XD is equal to XD into KD. This is odd round operation. For each odd round, the four blocks are converted in this fashion. Now coming to even round. In even round, we have four blocks of plain test, XA, XB, XC and XD. We have only two keys, KE and KF. If plain test size and block size, if plain test size and key sizes are equal, it is very simple to calculate the cipher test. So according to odd round algorithms. But coming to even round, we have four blocks of plain test, but key has only two blocks. For that purpose, these two are converted into two blocks. So assume two parameters y in or z in. Consider two parameters y in and z in. Y in value is changed as xa, xr, xb. Perform xr operation on these two terms, we are getting y in. And perform xr operation on these two terms, we are getting xd, z in. So y in and z in are completed. We have two blocks and we have two keys. Two blocks and two keys. Now get the result. So based on this, to get the result, we are applying some Mangler function. We are applying some Mangler function to get the result. So we will show this in the form of diagram. XA, XB, XC, XD. The first step is XA and XB are XRD. We are getting a result Y in. By performing XR operation, we are getting a result Y in. Similarly, XC and XD are XR. We are getting a result Z in. Now these Y in and Z in, these two inputs are applied to some Mangler function. So simply Mangler function is a difficult function. So these are the inputs Y in and Z in, two plain text inputs. For this we are applying two keys. The two keys are KE and KF. The two keys are KE and KF. So two plain text blocks, two key blocks. It produces result of two blocks. For example, the inputs are Y in and Z in. Assume the outputs are Y out and Z out. The outputs are Y out and Z out. But after getting this output, our aim is we are getting a cipher test of four blocks of plain test. For that purpose, we are performing XR operation. this XA and this Y out. XA and Y out, we are getting new XA value. XA and Y out, we are getting new XA value. Similarly, this XB and Y out, XB and Y out, we are getting YA value. Same time, Z out and XC, we are getting XC value. Z out and XD, we are getting XD value. That is simply XA is equal to XA and Y out. XB is equal to XB, Y out. XC is equal to XC, Z out. XD is equal to XD, Z out. So in this way we are getting the ciphertext, that is the output of the odd rounds. Here in this procedure we have to know what is the value of Y out and Z out. So here the procedure is, the four blocks are converted into two blocks. The names of the two blocks are Y in and Z in, and these two blocks along with these two keys are applied to some function. After applying function, it produces some result Y out and Z out. To get text of four blocks, we are performing these operations. In this process, by applying Mangler function, we are getting some Y out value, Z out value. So what is the value of Y out and Z out? In this, the value of Y out and Z out. So the value of Y out is simply KE into Y in, KE into Y in plus KE into Y in plus some other input plus Z in, KE into Y in plus Z in plus K into Y plus Z in. Observe XA, so Y in into KE plus Z in, another input is XB. Similarly Z out value is KE into Y in, KE into Y in plus Y out value plus Y out value. This is the procedure of, that is in Mangler function, we are getting these two values, that is Y out value and Z out values. So Y out value is simply Y in into KE plus Z in into KF, into KF. So we are applying two keys, KE and KF, and Z out value is KE into Y in plus Y out. So in this way, we are performing encryption algorithm. So, simple terms, IDEA algorithm is divided based on number of rounds. IDEA has 17 number of rounds. Odd rounds perform algorithm in one fashion. Event rounds perform algorithm in another fashion. Thank you.